And the independent senator, Jacqui Lambie, actually worked with Michael Mosley on a documentary about sleep or the lack of it. And she joins us now. Jacqui, how do you feel about that development out of Greece this morning?
I think it's really sad. I think once he was missing for 24 hours, you know, I think a lot of us probably knew that there was something had gone terribly wrong. So, look, what a fabulous bloke, honestly. You cannot fault Michael whatsoever. And his sense of humour, I'll never forget his sense of humour. You know, filming with him on that sleep, about the sleep deprivation, his sense of humour really, really came out. He's just really a genuine bloke with a big heart, you know, that really wanted to make a difference out there. I met him the first time, actually, Pete, when he was doing the diabetes and how quickly within 6 to 8 weeks, you know, you could move that type 2 diabetes down even further. It was absolutely amazing. And they're right about him. Just simple words out of his mouth. He knew how to communicate with all walks of life. And I think that's what made him so fabulous. Yeah. But yeah, just a really genuine guy, mate. Okay. Real grateful.
Yeah.
And I have to say, you know, there's one thing I have to say. God just takes such good people too early. And he was one of those great people.
No, good point. Let's get to the politics of the day, Jacqui, and in particular on energy. Peter Dutton, he will not leave the Paris Climate Agreements and is committed to 2050. However, when it comes to 2030 and 2035, he wants more economic detail. What do you make of this and the potential problems this could be for him when it comes to inner city seats that he really needs to win back?
I just don't know whether they're going to hit their target like they say it will.
So best to be honest and upfront about it?
I think he needs to be honest and upfront about it if he isn't going to hit that target. If you're not going to hit that target, I don't think, you know, people are going to jump up and down, but I suggest you get in early and let them know you're probably not going to hit that target. You know, I'm a supporter, and I've said that for nuclear energy as well, but, you know, if there's one thing I learned about 6 or 7 years ago on a fuel security Senate inquiry was that nuclear was going to take years and years and years, and we're still sitting here talking about it and not doing anything about that. So I think all energy mixes should be on the table, full stop.
Yeah, so this is the right approach then, in your view, that Peter Dutton's taking?
I think that certainly looking at nuclear, but I suggest they get onto it, stop the waffling and actually start looking into it and actually something.
Because what
I don't
about
want
cutting
to see it in another 10 years, mate.
Sorry, Jacqui. Yeah, just cutting those targets, you know, the 2030, 2035, saying, let's not worry about that. We're not going to achieve it anyway. I want more economic details on that before I commit to it. Is that the right approach?
Of course, we'd all love to achieve that target. And if they can't make it, we need to know why they can't make it and see what else needs to be put in the mix.
Yeah.
But the PM needs to be honest about that. And if we can't make it, then let's do something to try and make it without putting that pressure on already living expenses that are out there, you know. And I think this is something that needs to be open for discussion.
Hey, this is a question that I've been asking people today because a lot of people, particularly COVID victims, are not happy about it. The Australian Aoners, Dan Andrews and Mark McGowan, two of the most divisive COVID-era premiers, they get the top awards today at the King's Birthday Honours List. How do you feel about it?
Well, COVID or no COVID, but parliamentarians are paid to do a job, and what we need awards now to tell us that we're doing a job. I don't believe in this the award system for the Australian Day Honours. I think they've gone right off their head, I'll be honest with you, and they should be given out there to everyday Australians, not politicians, who are paid to do the job anyway. You don't get awards. We're all grown-ups now. It's not a race. Just get the job done.
Would you accept one if you got one eventually?
No, I wouldn't. I wouldn't accept one. I'd be very heartfelt. There's no doubt about that. But quite frankly, I get paid over $200,000, Pete, to do a job up there, and part of my job is making sure I get results.
Yeah.
And that doesn't include medals, mate. Sorry, I'm just not into them.
Good point, Jacqui Lambie. Good to see you as always. We'll chat to you soon.